Let's see. Now let's look at it. All right, we're looking at just the top. Now crank it down a little bit more. All right, so today I'm going to be working on this part of the white building, green windows and such. Generals, pastels, sea green with some white is what I'm going to be using for the windows in the white building. I'm not going to be having any music playing anymore because every time I do, even though I try to find copyright-free stuff, it ends up being copyrighted by somebody somewhere, and YouTube doesn't like it, so I'm tired of that. So I'm just going to have my headphones on, and you'll be able to just clearly hear nothing but the sound of drawing. I was told by one of the people in my figure drawing classes that the sound of me drawing would be something that people would want to listen to. So, giving it a try. Number 700. I call it cement. because it's kind of a the lightest gray they have, and it does have a kind of a cement color to it, or concrete, whatever you want to call it, that kind of light gray, almost white but not quite. It shows that it's darker in that spot, so darken it up a little more too. Lighten up just a little bit more. Not a lot, just enough. All right, there we go. One window down. Get this shadow in here. It looks like the window sills around the window are just white like the building. So I will get to those when I get to the white. Now let's get that little one. Sharpen this up a bit. My washcloth. Keep that cleanliness. Let's see. Looks like it just goes to the bottom of the arch. I have it drawn all the way to the top, but no, it's at the bottom of the arch right there. All right. Let's go for it. Like that. Door itself. Even a little bit of dark in that corner. Whoops. Sorry. Didn't mean to knock you guys around. I used to have my camera that low. Thank you. You see me spin and twist my pencils on a regular basis. Like, you know, I'm always trying to find the sharper spot because after you run down a little bit, it gets flat. So you twist it and get a sharper edge. Something I learned way back in high school in mechanical drafting class. Where, yeah, we had to sharpen all of our pencils by hand like I do now. So it's been a habit, like 30 years. It's part of the reason why sometimes I drop my pencils. It's not just because I clumsy. It's just I'm in the middle of my flip and twist and I miss. And then when I'm using a brush like this, I have to resist the temptation to flip and twist. It's kind of funny, but not. That real quick. music. Back to the cement color for the blending. little greener. It's not the frame, inside frame of the window that's green. It's just reflecting that green tint of the shade. So we've got to have a little bit in there, or it's just going to look gray. And that's not what it is. Oops, sorry guys. Kick you with my toe. This one's actually facing out. Thank you. All right, so next part is the green and dark gray. grab a drink. I'm getting thirsty.
Come on, Suki.
Little light blue because it's picking that up from the sky. Whoops. Stay on the dark side. Mm. I'm not pressing hard either. These things just break easy. They're just so delicate. Mm-hmm. Good thing I just got a box of 12 of these pure whites from Stabilo, number 100. It's the last I have. But for the white on this building, I'm going to be using Nupastels white. Get it clean here so I don't contaminate it, but it's got one of the purest whites I've seen in a soft pastel. So vibrant and bright. See if I can get the edge with the CarbOthelo. Of course, now I have to resharpen it. instead of whittling it down to this, I use the mechanical sharpener, but then I take the sandpaper and go further with it and get that fine point, because it won't get that being a soft pastel. It keeps breaking. So you have to like sand it to the soft point, sharp point you want. In case anyone is wondering, I got a paper bag on the floor I tap this into, keep the dust confined. That's going to work. I don't need the full bright white on this side. I'm going to use this to kind of lighten it some, then add my purple and gray to it. That's what our shadows are in the white. It's kind of a lavender with different tones of gray, unless it picks up some other color around it. Lavender. Then we've got our darker cream yellow, which will also kind of brighten some areas but mute the purple, being a complementary color. Back half is lighter than the front half. It's not quite that yellow, it's more white. Always try a practice stroke first. Kind of like in golf. You see the guys take a practice swing to get that line up. A little sharper. Guys, it's 2 hours. I gotta go sit down for a minute and take me a small 15-minute break or so. I'll be right back.
All right, people, I'm back.
Open a new box and hopefully they're not broken. Now when I saw this box, I'm like, they better not have sent me red Stabilos. But no, it's 12 pieces and on the back it says white. Smells like success. So far, they do not like the electric sharpener. Keep crumbling. All right, so when sharpening by hand, that's what you start off with. Just take the wood down and clean it off the shaft or core. Then take it to your trusty sandpaper pad. Oh, look at this, crumbling and shattering. These are brand new too, so glad I got this on film. Might send them a letter. Let's see if a different pencil works better. There's also a binder, like glue, between the wood and the core. You try to get as much of that off as possible, too. Let's try this again. So far, so good. I'm going to just spin that one pencil, hopefully. You can tell, but I can tell. See how white this is compared to this white? It's just a not quite as bright as new pastel. So the way I'm going to fix that is because I want it to be as bright. See, I can't be as accurate with these things because they're so soft. So I can't do thin lines, but I can do that and then go and erase what I don't want. Hmm.
See how dark it is. It's actually not too bad. Sir.
Now I could put the hard Stabilo on top of the soft new pastel, and it stays as bright as it was. But just this by itself is not as bright. I really need that cream color. Maybe kind of a terracotta. Yeah, there was some kind of eraser gunk stuck there. Into there. Thank you. It was just too long. I'm not putting white on there. I'm using it to scrape off the rubber. Really, I could use the just make sure it's clean. I know I have a bad habit of holding every pencil in my hand at once.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Turn the fan on. I'm starting to sweat. Mm-hmm. I swear half of the time takes to do this whole thing is the sharpening. Thank you. I'm sorry, I'm getting in the way, but got to.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's all for today, guys. I'm tired. Sore. Logging out.